first of all, congratulations to Utah State. I mean, they hung in there, and we certainly could have done some things better in timely fashion. I thought our team continued to fight and compete. Obviously, we made some change at quarterback, and I think that there's some real positive elements to that. I understand there's going to be questions following that. I'll be more than happy to answer any of those questions. You know, Utah State was a really prolific offense. I don't think the scoreboard really indicates the effort that our defensive players did. And so we need to build off of that. We've got a short week getting ready for Colorado State, but I want to congratulate Utah State. They came in and beat us. So, questions? Robert. I'm going to go with Robert. He raised his hand first.
Craig, you know, talk about the decision to play Sean, you know, and then at the end, you know, you had got the ball late but had Tyler in there. Did you just not feel like Sean was ready for that situation? Could you address both those?
I'm not going to get into all the specifics, but I can tell you we looked at the timing of the game. And Coach Vegan and I were communicating back and forth. And when the decision came, when you know we felt like we had stopped them on the fourth down and one, and they ruled that it was a first down, I knew that the time was going to come to the point. And then when we got the holding call, you know, we were backed up that amount of time with that amount of timeouts. Tyler had run 2-minute offense proficiently, you know, against Wofford, and I understand this is a different defense than Wofford, but that was a decision to put our football team the best chance to win. Yes.
Confidence-wise, did you feel like Tyler could lead you guys?
Yes. Yeah, without question, felt confident about Tyler. You know, we got to recognize he's 20 years old, but he led us on a drive earlier in the year. He's operated the 2-minute offense well, and that was our decision. Yes, Robert.
Your thoughts on Sean, just in his time and maybe what you do moving forward. Does he start? Do you move forward with him now? How do you
We're certainly going to look at that. I've learned a long time ago to make a decision like that right after a game, right after in a press conference, usually is pretty short-sighted. But I can tell you he did a lot of good things. We're going to take a look at the tape. We got a short night. We'll be working and practicing tomorrow, getting ready for the Rams. Yes.
If you decide to go with him more, do you think he will pass more? Was it just getting him into more passing situations?
You know, those things, we certainly need to open up the playbook more. But we'll look at who's our quarterback next week. Yes.
How much of the offense are you comfortable with him running? How much does he know it at this point?
Well, anytime you have a true freshman, you know, we have a complicated offense. Yeah. It's a pro-style offense. And so we'll look at those things. But we got to decide who our quarterback is. Like I said, we're going to look at the tape. Heck, I'll probably watch the tape tonight. And, you know, we'll make some decisions as the week goes along. I think we've got two really competitive guys here. Yes, in the back.
Hey, Coach, I know the questions have been mainly about the quarterback. Yeah. Let's switch it to the defense. After that third play of the game, they ran a 56-yard touchdown. What did you feel about the way you guys bounced back to hold that for a little bit?
That was a high-risk, high-reward defensive call. And kudos to them. They came off the table and had a big run. But I was really pleased and proud of how our defense played. I mean, I thought the quarterback got out of rhythm. I thought our guys swarmed to the football. We got some takeaways. That's a prolific offense, so we were pleased with that. But we've got to come up with another play here. Obviously, I think the play that really hurt was the kickoff return. And, you know, some things we've got to work on with the coverage, and it was a poor kick. So. Yes, Robert.
You mentioned the special teams. The kickoff return hurt. You know, Cooper had some, you know, kicked the field goals well, but then, you know, you had some punt, you know, kickoff out of bounds. Was it a mixed bag, I guess, so to speak, special teams wise?
Yeah, I would say a mixed bag. You know, Cooper's been great on field goals. I don't know if he's missed one this year. But the kick out of bounds, their kicker's a good kicker. He kicked one out of bounds and then put the kick down the middle. That one hurt. But we got to cover that better. Yes.
Did you sense a different energy level, a different confidence from your team when you made the switch at quarterback?
You know, our players are going to support whoever we put out there. So, you know, I'm going to let it sit at that.
You mentioned also the penalties. I mean, a lot of penalties, and again, a lot of times it's on some of your veteran guys. And no matter who it's on, I know you don't want to see them, but is that starting to get a little unnerving, a little bit, seeing that those type of mistakes?
You know, I was particularly disappointed in the jumps off sides. Those are the things that really hurt us. Yep. Yes.
What's the challenge in turning around with a short week with a rival coming up?
Well, the challenge is you got about 118 guys in the locker room got their divers low, and you've got a coaching staff to put everything they had into this of a couple tough weeks. And the challenge is getting those guys back, which we as coaches will do. And for us as coaches, get a bounce back in our step. Colorado State and Wyoming have had a long tradition. It'll be your first time experiencing it. And so, but you know, we say we got a 24 hours. We're going to amend that to probably to 18, maybe to 12.
Is there any updates on injuries from this game, or do you have any word yet?
You know, we were a little bit concerned about Tyler Hall, but he was able to continue. So outside of that, there was nothing new that that came to me. That doesn't mean something may pop up tomorrow, but I didn't see anything. Yes?
You were looking at a couple of fourth and shorts on the other side of the 50, decided to punt it. Kind of what was your thought process with that?
Well, one of the things was we were playing really good defense and we were having a hard time running the football. You know, when you say fourth and short, I can remember a fourth and one. Some of the other ones were a little bit fourth and long twos and felt like that was a little bit outside. If we would have been struggling defensively, I probably would have looked at it differently, but I thought we were getting great push. I thought we had them off kilter, so that was my thoughts. Yes.
Velasquez's situation?
Pardon me?
Velasquez.
Alonzo. I would say he'd be doubtful for next week. Mm-hmm. That certainly hurt as well. Other questions? Who's coming in here, Tim?